Honestly, I did not think I was going to be able to find work. I thought I was going to be a stay-at-home mom forever and not by choice, just because nobody was going to hire me or, you know, I wouldn't be able to keep up with this changing world.
A digital shift is changing the world as we know it. Innovations in technology have created entirely new jobs, and the way we get those jobs is changing too. Temsy Chen, a mother of two, has zero experience in tech work and had been out of the workforce entirely for nearly 10 years.
I really felt like all my bridges have been burned, like all my knowledge is obsolete. So yeah, I never thought I would move into tech, but I also had no idea that these kinds of jobs existed, right? Like the term data science, it didn't exist 10 years ago.
By 2030, it's estimated that there will be a global shortage of more than 85 million tech workers. Because of this, we've seen a rapid rise in online learning boot camps that aim to replace the traditional four-year university. Temsy went from a stay-at-home mom to becoming a data engineer in less than a year.
When I decided to switch careers, it really started this life 2.0 feeling for me.
Once again, technology is changing work as we know it. Are you ready? These are the blue, white, and no-collar jobs of today and the future.
So this is my home office. This used to be where I did all my crafting, but I've changed it all now so that this is my tech space. This is where I work. This is how I learned when I was at BloomTech. As a data engineer, I code all day. I help automate things. I move data around. I'm either taking pre-existing code or I'm writing it. You can think of it almost like a data plumber.
We live in a world ruled by data. From understanding buying behaviors to discovering cures for diseases, big data has made it possible to find insights imperceptible to human pattern recognition.
Of all the complicated things, like, I don't know, that I've learned in my life, I feel like this one is definitely not the hardest. And I think it's partly because there's so much demand for this kind of work right now. And because of that, there's all these industries around helping people get there.
The Bureau of Labor Statistics estimates that the tech workforce is projected to grow 15% over the next decade.
So before tech, I was a stay-at-home mom for 9 years. You know, I really threw myself into being a stay-at-home parent. I participated and volunteered in all the kids' activities and their schools. But as soon as my youngest was ready to go to school, I was really ready to go to work. So when I decided to go to data science, my husband had found this program online called BloomTech. It was online virtual learning. You know, you could learn to be a web developer or you could go into data science. The biggest reason I went with this bootcamp as opposed to any others is that they had this thing called an ISA.
An ISA, or income sharing agreement, is an arrangement where you don't pay for your tuition until you land a job making above a certain salary. Or to put it simply,
they don't get paid until I get paid. To me, that was so important, right? I had kids. I didn't want to put myself in debt. And this seemed like the most risk-free option.
The conventional path to the tech industry is a bachelor's degree from a four-year university. But it's not the only path. For Temsy, BloomTech's flexibility allowed her to learn on her own time and graduate in only 10 months.
I thought for sure that if I went back to work, that I would be making 5 digits. But now I'm making low 6 figures. And that was really surprising, right? It really surpassed all my expectations. If I had to switch careers again in 10 years, I think that would be okay. I just think anything's possible at this point. I see things and think about things in a totally different way.
As online learning proliferates alongside the growing demand for tech workers, non-traditional paths will open doors to the tech world for more and more workers, including those who may never have ended up in tech otherwise.
I came into this with no background. And, you know, if you've ever picked up a new hobby, I think it was just kind of like that. You know, if you follow a recipe at the end, if you've never made a cake before, you'll have a cake at the end. And I really felt like this was no different. There's a lot of opportunities out there, so you just have to go get it. I still feel like an outsider when it comes to tech. Maybe that'll change with time, but I kind of like being seated in that position where it still feels really new.